been held by a Savior. I've felt fire from above. I've been down to the river. I ate the train of prodigal return. Thank God that yesterday's gone. All my sins are forgiven. And I've been washed by the blood. I'm no stranger to the prison. I've worn shackles and chains, but I've been freed and forgiven. And I'm not going back, I'll never be the same. There's a kind of thing that just breaks a man, break him down to his knees. God, I've been broken more than a time or two. Yes, Lord, then he picked me up and showed me what it means to be a man.
Christmas, everybody. Raise your hand if you are super excited that the waiting is over, that Christmas has finally come. Thank you. I'm very appreciative of all the kids that shot their hands up right away. We are so thankful that we get to gather together today, that we get to say Merry Christmas, that we get to celebrate the birth of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, that the Prince of Peace has arrived. Today, whether you are here in this room with us, whether you are on our live stream, wherever you are at, know that today is a day of celebration, that today is a day of great things. And one of the things that we always use to mark a day of celebration are candles. If you are here with us in the room, you have a candle on your chair. Wait, we'll be using that a little bit later on. If you're on our live stream today, we already threw this in the chat, but make sure, take a moment, go around your house, find a candle wherever you are at. We'll give some further instructions a little bit later on. For all of you that are here today, my name is Kyle. I'm here on staff at ACTS Church Lakeway. Let me welcome you to our worship gathering. Let us welcome you to this time that we get to gather together. Let us all be welcomed to a wonderful day, a wonderful time where we get to celebrate the birth of our Savior. Let's do some songs to kick it off.
You guys sing Joy to the World with me, okay? All right, here we go.
As we usually do, we're going to be reading the story of the birth of Jesus together. The words are going to appear upon the screen. Please read along with me from Luke 2. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria. And everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born. And she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them.
And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. you will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger. Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." And this prophecy is obviously fulfilled by Jesus in Bethlehem. And that's why you just saw a moment ago we lit the Christ candle, because he is here for all of us. Let's continue to worship. Welcome again. Over here we have Jason, Ryan, I'm Danielle, and this is Andrew, and we are just so blessed to get to worship together, especially to hear all of the beautiful voices that we're getting to hear today. And don't worry, live stream folks, I'm sure you're doing a lovely job as well. Another joy that we get to do is profess our faith together. So please join me in these words from the Apostles' Creed on the screen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the forgiveness of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Thank you guys very much.
At this time, I would love to invite all our kids up here on the stage. We are going to do a little lesson for our kids.
Yeah, so all of our kids head on up. While the kids are heading up, Mr. John, everyone say hi to Mr. John.
Hey, everybody.
Mr. John is a very special friend of mine. He also works with us here at ACTS Church Lakeway. I felt while the kids are coming up, you guys go ahead and have a seat right here. Have a seat right there. This would be a great time to give Mr. John my Christmas present from me to you.
Kyle, you didn't have to do that.
My wife said I had to.
Well, this is so nice of you.
I mean, I'm very happy to do that. Now, here is the one thing. It's a Christmas present, so you have to wait to open it, right? Or Alex says 2023, so wait a little bit longer. Now, boys and girls, I want to tell you guys a really cool story. We heard it a little bit ago, but today is the day that we get to celebrate that Jesus... Hey, John, stop.
Sorry.
Thank you. Today is the day that we get to celebrate that Jesus has been born. Christmas, we've gotten to this period of waiting where we've been waiting for this to happen and waiting for... John, seriously.
Kyle, it's really hard to wait.
Okay, but they have to wait.
Well, yeah, yeah.
Just let me tell the story. So Mary and Joseph traveled all the way to a little town of Bethlehem. John...
Sorry.
Okay, you're distracting the young children. Well, now, here's, all right, so boys and girls, here's the thing. We have been waiting. Raise your hand if you've been waiting for Christmas for a little bit. Raise your hand if you've been waiting a lot of bit. Raise your hand if you've been waiting a lot, a lot, a lot, a lot, a lot, a lot of bit. That was like 13 lattas. Okay, that is a long, long time. The same thing was happening. Hear me out.
Okay.
Because we've been in this period of waiting. Not only are we waiting now, but all the way back when Jesus was born, those people were waiting. They were waiting for a Savior, and they didn't have to wait days. They didn't have to wait weeks. They didn't wait months. They didn't wait a few years. They were waiting years and years and years and years and years. And they waited and waited, and then on that first Christmas, guess what? They didn't have to wait anymore.
Ooh.
Because Jesus was born. The waiting was over. The Savior of the world had come. That's pretty good news, huh?
That is great news. And that's probably, I mean, I know that's better than any gift you could give me.
That is better than any gift I could give you. That is a phenomenal point, John. John made a great point. Should I give him a reward? Should I let him open his present?
I heard some yeses.
I heard, let's not ignore, we heard some no's.
But Kyle, I'm...
We did hear a very loud yes, a few yeses.
Yeah.
Let's let Mr. John open up his gift, because I actually think it will help us make this point.
Good.
So, Mr. John, here, I'll hold your mic for you.
Oh, thank you.
You're very welcome. That's aggressive. You're an adult. You don't need to open quite like that.
Ooh.
Oh! What do we have here?
Well, this looks like an ornament that says peace.
It says peace. Now, why would I give you something that says peace this Christmas season, seeing how we've been waiting this whole time?
Well, now that Christ is born, our waiting is over.
Our waiting is over.
Our waiting is over, and peace is a great reminder that we are made whole with Jesus and God and with each other. So this is going to be awesome on my tree.
That is phenomenal. Can we give Mr. John a round of applause? He did such a good job today. He did so good. In fact, I'm going to forget the fact that he didn't give me a gift. And we are going to move on. We're going to have Mr. John say a quick prayer for all of us as we celebrate that the waiting is over, that the peace of the world has come, and that Christ has saved every single one of us. We are so thankful. Mr. John, why don't you lead us? Let's all fold our hands. Let's all bow our heads, and let's pray.
Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, just thank you for today. Thank you for the fact that you have given us the greatest gift in your Son, Lord. Just remind us always that we are made whole with you and that we are made whole with each other because of what you did through Christ and sending him to us. We are so thankful for that, and we just celebrate that he came and was born on Christmas. In your name I pray. Amen.
Amen. Kids, you can go ahead and have a seat as we continue on. Thank you guys very much.
Slave is above and in his name. Grace, mercy, and peace be unto you from God our Father and our Lord and Savior, Jesus, who is the Christ. Amen? Yeah. So, this year, it's actually from John and his wife, Jordy. It's called Advent of the Cocktail Hour. This is an adult gift. If you've noticed, this one's from Trader Joe's. If you've noticed Christmas this year, there are Advent calendars all over the place. There are cocktail Advent calendars. There's beer, wine. We've got our own little Advent calendar here. The word Advent actually means waiting. Well, it implies waiting. It actually means an arrival or a coming. But if you're waiting for somebody to show up, you're going to wait, right? You're going to have to wait. People actually have been counting down for Christmas in a lot of different ways. For some people, it's kind of waiting for that pile of gifts to grow under the tree. For other people, you've got an Advent wreath. Maybe you've got one at home. We've actually been lighting candles every Sunday, and now tonight, the Christ candle for the first time. I don't know how you count down to Christmas. Maybe for you, it's sending out cards or receiving those or making Christmas cookies. All different kinds of waiting. For me, I'm going to be enjoying the advent of the cocktail hour. 24th, here we are. The waiting is over. Let's see what's in here. Jeff, that's for you. Are you over 21? No. He's not 21, is he? Okay. You're going to have to just watch your dad enjoy that. The 24th. We've been waiting the whole season. Let's see what's the 23rd. Was that good? All right, Patrick, that one's for you. Whoa, man, 23rd. That one, I don't even know what that is. Is it good? Okay, yeah, let's do one more. Let's see how my aim is way back there. Yeah, these all have liquor in them, just so you know. Mark Norsha, this is coming your way. Oh, so close. Hey, if you're at home, don't worry. There's more up front. So this is actually the approved Advent calendar for ACTS Church Lakeway. Thank you, Danielle. And each week we've been opening up another door in these little gift wrap packages. And every Sunday we've had an item, an object, a person, and a little word. You've already seen the word for today. It's the word peace. But in the 24th, as we count down, we actually have a little ornament. Actually, on screen, you're going to be able to see this a little bit better. This is actually from the little town of Bethlehem in Israel. It's made out of olive wood. And you can see the star there with Mary and Joseph and the babe. This is a reminder that as we focus on an aspect of the Christmas story tonight, we're focusing on a place. It's not a concept. It's not something like faith or joy. It's actually a physical place. I don't know what you know about the town of Bethlehem, but my guess is that whatever might be in your mind is slightly different than what's actually going on in Bethlehem. That actually introduces a continuation of the Christmas story. You heard the Luke 2 passage. Matthew's gospel also has a perspective. This takes place after the birth of Jesus. In Matthew's gospel, there's just kind of one sentence that speaks about Jesus being born. We don't have the full account with the angels and shepherds and everything else in Matthew's gospel. But this is where Matthew picks up, chapter 2. Now, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem saying, "Where is the one who has been born king of the Jews? For we saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him." Now when Herod the king heard this, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem was with him. And assembling all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, he inquired of them where, back to that place, where is it that Christ was to be born? And they said to him, because they knew the Old Testament prophecies, and they said, "In Bethlehem of Judea. For you, Bethlehem, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for out of you shall come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel." And then Herod summoned the wise men secretly and ascertained from them what time the star had appeared. And he said to them, "Go to Bethlehem Search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word that I too may come and worship him. After listening to the king, they went on their way, and behold, the star that they had seen when it rose went before them until it came to rest over the place where the child was. And when they saw the star, they rejoiced exceedingly with great joy. And going into the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they fell down and worshipped him. Then opening their treasures, they offered him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh. Most of us don't know much about the actual town of Bethlehem. Maybe what you sing in the song, you're going to sing it actually in just a minute, a little town of Bethlehem, how, what is it? Still we see thee lie. Above thy deep and dreamless sleep, the silent stars go by. Read it with me. Yet in thy dark streets shineth the everlasting light. The hopes and fears of all the years are met in thee tonight. That really sounds soothing, doesn't it? Sounds calm. Actually, the little town of Bethlehem was anything but calm. In fact, if you go there today, it's not exactly the Bethlehem of our dreams and our carols. If you go there today, you'll actually see one of these running right through the town. It's called the Separation Wall. Bethlehem is actually on the west bank of Israel. You've probably heard about some of the conflict between the Palestinians and the Jewish people. This 26-foot wall just zigzags through Israel. It's got barbed wire and watchtowers on the top. One travel blogger describes it as a hulking concrete snake that twists and turns its way throughout the land, lining highways, surrounding villages, and cutting through cities. This is Bethlehem today. It's a Palestinian town being encroached upon by Jewish settlements. There's a lot of division if you go there today. And if we go back in time all the way to the ancient world, Bethlehem was also, it's kind of a shady story. If you go into the book of Judges, there are actually two stories connected with Bethlehem, kind of two strikes against it. The first story is, I'm not going to actually ruin your Christmas by reading the stories, but the first one has to do with some just rank idolatry and a bloody massacre. Two chapters later, Bethlehem shows up again, and there is a pretty graphic sexual sin followed by a dismembered body. Again, we're not going to read the stories tonight. But you look, this is Bethlehem. This is the town that God chose for the birth of his son. What's going on here? Well, I think God was trying to communicate that even among his people, darkness and sin had taken hold. There's a great line in the New Testament that talks about the domain of darkness. And this is the world into which Christ was born. But that's not all there was to the story, because the Old Testament continues. There's a woman named Naomi. She's an Ephrathite. She and her husband and her sons, they're from the town of Bethlehem. They're from the smallest clan of Judah, the Ephrathites. And they actually leave Bethlehem. The word Bethlehem means house of bread, but ironically, during this time, there is no bread. There's a famine. And so they leave and they go over to Moab. And this is where her daughter-in-law, Ruth, gets involved in the story. And if you look at the lineage of Jesus, the Messiah, Ruth is listed in the lineage. And even now, God has taken this place and he's weaving his thread of redemption. He's buying it back. He's changing the story. He's making it whole again. He's bringing peace, making things right. And then the prophet Micah speaks 700 years before the birth of Christ. And this is what he says: "But you, O Bethlehem Ephrathah," there's that word, this little clan, "who are too little to be among the clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to be ruler in Israel, whose coming forth is from of old, from ancient days." You might also acknowledge Bethlehem being the place that King David comes from. King David, the youngest and smallest son of Jesse. In fact, the prophet goes through every one of his sons trying to find the new king, and then finally goes, "Isn't there anybody else?" And the father says, "Well, I got this runt of a kid. He's out there watching the sheep." And so Samuel the prophet says, "Well, send for him." And the minute he comes in, Samuel says, "This is the one." The Lord says that to him. What is it about the Lord that he chooses places like Bethlehem, that he takes the inconsequential, that he takes the unexpected and he moves his story not through the expected but through the unexpected. This runt of Jesse's line, David, is eventually going to become the greatest king of Israel. And this Jesus, born in a manger, is going to become Savior of the world. This is how God loves to operate. If you want to pick the important place, you would go to Jerusalem, wouldn't you? This is the place of political power. This is the place where all the important people are. You would not go to Bethlehem. Bethlehem's filled with ordinary people doing ordinary things. So how do we understand what God is up to? Well, have you heard the name Bruce Lee before? Who's heard of Bruce Lee? Anybody? All right, if you don't know who Bruce Lee is, I'm gonna give you a quiz. We're going to give everybody the chance to get on the page together. Here's your Christmas quiz. Bruce Lee is best known for A, his holiday cookie recipes on Pinterest. B, what's choice B? His smooth jazz guitar albums. Or C, his martial arts movies from the 1970s. Don't shout it out loud. Are you getting your answer? Don't give it away to somebody. Yeah, we actually have a picture of Bruce Lee. He died very young. Yeah, since most cooking shows on Pinterest leave their shirts on, we're going to go with letter C, martial arts from the 1970s. Bruce Lee was actually born in Hong Kong. He's known for bringing East and West together. He actually created the foundation for MMA. You know what that stands for? Mixed martial arts. And he was also a philosopher. One time, one of his students asked him, it said, Mr. Lee, why is it that you're always talking about peace and yet every day you're training us on how to fight? And Bruce Lee looked at him and he responded, it is better to be a warrior in a garden than a gardener in a war. I believe this is what's going on at Christmas. Jesus comes as a warrior in a garden, and even though we're looking at peaceful things and poinsettias and candles and a little infant cooing in a manger, do not be deceived. There is a cosmic battle that is taking place. And in the middle of this, God the warrior steps in and he goes on offense. And he says, I'm going to win back the people that were in danger of being lost through sin and death and the power of the devil, and I'm going to bring them back to myself. Do not be deceived by ox and lamb and sheep. The warrior is breaking into this world. Look at this from Micah 2. The prophecy continues, and he shall stand and shepherd his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And read this with me. And they shall dwell secure, for now he shall be great to the ends of the earth, and he shall be their peace. Remember, Bethlehem is not only the place where the Messiah was born. Bethlehem, as the story continues in Matthew chapter 2, that's the location where King Herod, jealous for this Messiah, this coming king, has all the baby boys slaughtered, age 2 and younger. It's a terrible part of the story. This is what Christ came into, a warrior in a garden. And certainly he was great to the ends of the earth. Certainly the name of the Lord, the power of God was upon him. But he also came as a shepherd, and he is our peace. What I want you to understand is God did not wait for us to make our world right, to get it set for him to come. He didn't wait for us to establish peace. He actually stepped into the middle of our chaos. I'm not sure what kind of chaos you're experiencing. We thought we were done with COVID, right? Well, maybe not. I don't know where you're experiencing conflict, if that's in your family, if that's in your politics, if that's in health, if that's in just how you appear to the world, how you present yourself. But over your family, God speaks shalom, peace. Over our politics, God speaks wholeness. Over our health, God makes things right again. And in our loneliness, God makes his presence and love known. Christmas is not an isolated bubble separated from the rest of life. Christ steps into life as we live it, as we know it. And our job, we don't have to pretend, our job is just to receive. O Holy Child of Bethlehem, descend to us, we pray, cast out our sin and enter in, be born to us today. How is that possible? You're going to sing this in just a minute. For Christ is born of Mary and gathered all above, while mortals sleep, the angels keep their watch of wondering love. O morning stars, together proclaim thy holy birth, and praises sing to God the King, and peace to men on earth. Isaiah called Jesus the Prince of Peace. The angels announcing to the shepherds said, peace on earth, goodwill toward men. And all this took place in the little town of Bethlehem, an ordinary place filled with ordinary people doing ordinary things, kind of like us. Don't be deceived. Don't look at the smallness, because in that, the gospel is present. And the gospel changes lives. The gospel beats back sin and darkness. The gospel moves from darkness into light. Do not be deceived by this little gospel. It is powerful. And it's seen in the face of Christ. And read these words together. For he has rescued us from the dominion of darkness and brought us into the kingdom of the Son he loves, in whom we have redemption, the forgiveness of sins. Merry Christmas.
Still we see thee lie above thy deep and dreamless, the silent stars go by, yet in thy dark street shineth the everlasting light, the hopes and fears of all these are met.
With me. Lord God, Heavenly Father, we are grateful for this day, because on this day we observe the greatest climax in history, a world filled with darkness that was in the domain of the devil and the hold of sin and death, and yet into that this light shone. We acknowledge that tonight, on this day. The birth of Christ our Savior, may that not just be a historical reality or a dry detail in the pages of some Bible, but may it be a truth that infects our lives and our hearts. And so we ask that you would come among us. We ask it in Jesus' name. Everyone agreed and said, amen. One of the things that we do as a church, you can see our mission on the wall, sending changed people into a changing world. One of the things that we do together is actually have an impact on our community. One of the things that you can do still today or all the way through January 2nd, we have a little effort called Keep Austin Warm, and we're collecting some things that go on this screen here, but socks and coats and hoodies, new or gently used, and we're collecting those at a station in our lobby. Beyond that, though, we are encouraging you to share the gospel, to carry this light of Christ where you live, learn, work, and play. We've been talking about that all year. Before you go, you're going to be given a specific task in that. As we sing this next song, we will collect an offering if you're at home. There is a link in our chat through which you might give electronically. If you're here with us in the room, we have a basket there in the back in the front of the sound booth. We invite you to use that if you'd like to make a gift today. Let's continue to sing.
We had said earlier that we needed you, wherever you're at, if you're on our live stream or you're here in person, to grab a candle. That candle is going to play an important part in the rest of our gathering. We have been saying that the waiting is over, the Prince of Peace has arrived, that Christ has come. That is what we get to celebrate today. That is what we get to live in each and every single one of these days. That the peace has come. That peace has made us right with God. That peace has also made us right with one another. Today is a celebration of what God has done for us. But we also know that we get to leave here today with a task, with a role to play in this world. The candle that you have is meant to represent someone. If you're here with us, those candles on our chairs, those are for you. Take one of those with you today. And what I want everyone to do right now is they hold that candle in your hand. Think of a person. This past year, we've been identifying people where we live, learn, work, and play as the areas that God might be calling us to. Today, in your mind, in your heart, identify one person. Identify one person where maybe you are living in your neighborhood, in your direct community. Maybe for students, it is someone that you are learning with, a classmate that you might have. Wherever you might work, a coworker, or someone that you might be dealing with in that setting. Or wherever you are just receiving recreation, wherever you are playing. Think about that person. And when you take this light with you, when you take this candle with you, this is meant to remind you of that person. Remind you today to pray for that individual, and then moving on from this day to take action. To find tangible ways to express the love of Christ, to find tangible ways to share the message of Christ, the hope and the peace that has come, that the waiting is over, to share it with those persons. Today we are going to be closing by singing Silent Night, and we're going to do it by candlelight. So we're going to hold these candles in our hand, we're going to hold these lights in our hand, and they're going to serve as a reminder both of what Christ has done for us, and then in turn what we are called to do and to be for others in our lives. So wherever you are, light those candles, whether it's from a switch on the bottom or a match, whatever it might be, but let us sing out with Christ in our heart and Christ in our mind.
Night, holy night.
really great being with you today. We appreciate the fact that you would spend part of your day with us together as a family. And as you go on your way, we will not meet this Sunday. We have a pre-recorded gathering that will be released at 10 o'clock on our normal channels, YouTube or website or app. January 2nd, we'll be back again. We would be more than pleased if you would join us for that on Sunday, January 2nd. Receive the benediction as God goes with you. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you his peace, which is always enough. In the name of Jesus, amen. Merry Christmas.